To the top, leveled up, now pouring champagne on the watch. Niggas is tripping, we moving dusty with the knock. Hit him from close range and knock him out his socks. Doing what we want, we been took over blocks. Son of niggas for fun, I ain't trying to be they pops. Suck my dick, I'm screaming that to the ops. Lemon pepper my wings, I had to do it for the block. Nigga, this is hallway rap. Niggas been trying for years, they ain't get that hallway back. From painting the red, I paint the hallway black. And I'll do it right here in front of hallway rap. Talking real rap. This ain't no cap. You'll catch one of these and take a all-way nap. Niggas been out here, I ain't always slack. Lemon pepper, I'll put your ass right in the sack. No cap.
Yo, Holy Rap TV, man. We here with another episode.
You know what I'm saying? Got my two guys here. I'm going to let them introduce themselves right here. Let's go. Introduce yourself.
Yo, it's the Kid Chronic. What's going on?
That's a fact. You know how I do on Holy Rap TV. I mean, y'all got some bars for me?
Yeah. First off, I'm from South Cack. I live in Harlem. Check out a District Kid. The song on Songbird. Song got my chronic called Throw Up Some Dough. Check it out, District Kid, Spotify, Apple Music, everything. Yo, I be about mine. I stay on the grind. I put in the time, want y'all to know. Don't care about shine money on my mind. I'm all about improving my flow. You don't see it, you must be blind, yo. Trying to live before I die, yo. Not running just to tie, yo. Be first to cross that line, yo. I go hard, yo. I leave it all on the floor. You might as well throw in the towel, because for you, there is no hope. Don't want to know what number two is. When I do it, I always do it to win. I'm all about my ends. This is not pretend. I don't follow. Yes, I set trends. I stand out. No, I don't fit in. I'm on a mission. Plenty times I dedicate. They hate to see you motivate, congratulate, and celebrate. Geechee.
That's a fact. Me hear something, bro. Me hear something.
All right, all right. Check me out, yo. You can hit me up on Instagram, my shit is official, Chronic42. I'm out on DistroKid. Go cop, go check out my mixtape, Greenhouse Onslaught, in stores and out right now on all social media platforms. Yo. New kid on the block, headed straight to the top. Tell them other boys to quit, cause this nigga don't stop. Can't stop, won't stop like Young Guns. I stays on the move like the monkeys in Temple Run. Tearing niggas down with these twisted lyrical puns. I'm something like Kane. Motherfuckers about to feel that pain. What he say? Who that boy? What's his name? Got these haters running frantic all over the game. When the storm is over, I'ma be the last to remain. And still, I maintain my shine. Stay on my grind. Chronic all about the Benjis like Cuban Mike. Trying to get for Richard, short matters of time.
Yeah.
What?
That's a fact. We out
here,
man.
You got
Hallway
Rap TV, yo.
Yo, sorry, we out here. Do it. What got y'all into the music? You can start first, bro.
I got into music because I like telling stories, and I used to DJ at high school, so I was always a fan of music, and eventually I just started doing it myself because it's in my blood, baby. Music is my life. Everything I talk about is my life, so it's all real, baby.
And how long you been doing it?
I've been doing music all my life.
So you grew up like you had a history in your family like of music, like inspired by the music.
I grew up down south, so yeah. Jukebox. We grew up on music. My aunt didn't play music all day, every day, you know. It's a suburb, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You learn from the elders, so you know.
So who were some of your inspirations coming up in the game?
My inspirations were, I listen to everybody. I pick a song from everybody, because like I said, I used to DJ, so you know, I pick it from everybody and bring it and make my own out of that. Like, I listen to R&B, hip-hop, rock and roll, jazz. I just love music, man, like, so I try to get inspirations from everything.
So what type of music do you make?
I make hip-hop, but I try to, you know, I got some songs that's like more up-tempo, like party music. I do real hustling music.
Got that down south feel, huh?
I mean, I grew up in the golden era.
Or you switched it
up. So I'm not like, I'm from the south, But I grew up listening to like Mobb Deep, Wu-Tang, Boot Camp, Click, you know, all the Golden Era shit. Like, it was like one of the few people in my town that was rocking Wu-Tang and shit. Like, you know, people looking at us like, what is that shit?
Yeah, word, right?
You know, they don't hear that. They was listening to Luke and shit like that. So, you know, I always stood out. We always stood out. And, you know, hip-hop is just a part of me. You know, I live it, breathe it, sleep it. That's you know, everything's a song to me. I got a song by sitting on the toilet, you know?
That's a fact. So what's up, bro? What got you into the music?
I've been influenced by the culture ever since, you know, I was a kid. I've been rapping since I was 11 years old. Like, I grew up listening to Lox, Beast Mons, Pac, Nas. Like, I really just started taking music seriously in my early 20s. But, like, I've been an MC. I'm a true spitter. Like, I've been rapping all my life. All my life, like.
So you like a lyricist? Like,
yeah. I do my own music. I write my own. I make my own beats. I write my own lyrics. Like, I do everything.
You got some fire, bro. I seen you at the Vera G joint.
Yeah, good looks. Yeah, good looks.
So you know what I mean?
It's gonna be a second to see it to remember you. That's my fault, but yeah, I appreciate
but,
that.
Being together, like y'all, I see y'all rocking together. So y'all collabed on a song or y'all just how did y'all meet?
I met him at the Kid Cody shit at Quad Studios.
He one day he had a showcase at Quad Studios. He was there, so we was all vibing. We was listening to each other rhymes, and maybe about a week later, me and him linked up in Harlem at Crab Queens. Queens, just to see what they was doing. Yeah. And we've been rocking ever since. Like, we've been doing shows. We'll be going out of state, rocking, doing shows and stuff like that.
Albany, VA, New Hampshire, Rhode Island.
Yeah, for the past few months now, a couple months.
So let me ask y'all a question. Either one of y'all can answer it. How do y'all approach collaborations with other artists? Like when y'all first meet them, when you first networking with them, like how do you feel that you want to make a song with the, is it the music? Is it the sound? Is it the performance? Is it, what is it that draw you into creating the music with another artist?
For me, I'm gonna be straight up and forward with you. It's your demeanor with me. Like, I can go up to a person and I can automatically know if I want to rock with this person with music, or can I fuck with this person? Automatic is your demeanor, how you carry yourself, and just how you are as a person. Yeah. Like, I literally fucks with music. I do music. Like, I don't mind working with other artists. It's just how you come about it. Like, I'm not the type of person to want drama in my circle type shit.
That's how you present yourself.
Yeah, you gotta know how to present yourself. That's all.
And be serious. Like, I don't like to waste time in the studio either. Like, get in and, you know, not just sit there all day and smoke and drink and nothing get done. That's why I do a lot of music by myself. But since I see him do music, I linked him up because I see he like to do music too. But I mostly do a lot of songs by myself because nobody gonna work as hard as me. Mm. You know what I'm saying? You know, that's just how I am.
How do y'all stay motivated in this game when people don't want to work with other artists, you know what I'm saying, and stuff like that? How do y'all stay motivated against that pressure?
Motivate myself. Me regardless. So, you know what I'm saying, regardless if I record anybody or not, I'm gonna still get it done.
That's a fact.
It's all about where you going. In this game, it's where you go, where you going, where you see yourself go, how far you want to go. If you really want to take this serious, then you have to maneuver through all the obstacles that come out your way. And, you know, that's what I'm doing right now. It's a whole bunch of bullshit that I'm going through. I got problems, but I don't let that deteriorate me from what I want to go as far as music and what I'm doing, you know? So, it's your drive, basically.
That's a fact. Like, do y'all see yourself in the next couple years or 5 years to now or 10 years from now, like you, I see myself still pursuing this dream, and where do y'all see yourself in the next 5 to 10 years?
Yo, I'm living the dream.
No,
I'm living the dream. I'm pursuing it. You know,
in the next 2 years,
I'm doing what I love to do. Five. So regardless of you know, I don't want to speak on camera, but you know, certain levels you got to get to. But I'm just happy to be living out my dream because I love to do music regardless. But never become where I want to go, I'm going to still be doing music because this is how I express myself. It's like my, you know, my therapy. So I'm going to write songs regardless if people never hear it.
Yeah, I'm
just like making music regardless. If I, you know, If I can get an inspired by anything, I'm gonna write a song. You may never hear that song, but at least I got it done because I like to write, me. I like to make stories, you know? Right. It's just me. You know, right. So I don't do it for the fame, I do it for the love.
I do it for the fans, but at the same time, I want to get paid too. I want to get paid too. I do this shit for the culture. I do a little thing. I ain't gonna say I'm the best like Drake or no shit like that, but I do this music shit for the culture.
Yeah.
I'm not saying I'm not saying that Drake is the best. I'm saying since
y'all did make a song together, like who would y'all want to make a collaboration with, like upcoming? Now it don't have to be a celebrity, it don't have to be, you know what I'm saying, but just upcoming, like who do y'all want to work with, like name a couple, like three, give me three a piece, like who would you want to work with?
I want to work with Moneybagg. Like I've been following Moneybagg in his career since he first started gotten into music, and I like a lot of his shit, so if I ever got into a collaboration with him, it would be Money. I would collab with Money. Who else? If I had the opportunity, I would work with Lil Wayne. God willing. No, seriously. Yeah. I'm a big Wayne fan too. I mean, if Jadakiss.
Give me some guys that you.
Me, I wouldn't work anybody long as they don't get too extreme. Like, I don't rap about killing or disrespecting women or, you know, so I got kids, so yeah. I like making music, but I try to keep it on a certain level because, you know, I'm willing to work with anybody as long as they don't go too far left, you know, because I got to represent from my family, you know.
Mm-hmm. So what's the name of the project that y'all came up with?
It's called Throw Some Dough, this is about celebrating, it's also the song. This is one out of two, we got another. Wicked Bay coming soon.
Oh, so yeah, so y'all gonna do an EP together or
something like
or album?
Three or four songs. I mean, if you got time, I'm always writing songs. Like I said, I got plenty of songs, just whenever you want to write, we write.
How was the feeling working together?
Cool.
I fucks with Lou. Like, Lou is like one of the only dudes I could really like vibe with without feeling like I don't worry about this person. Like, I know, seriously. I probably never said that shit about you. I don't mean it
no disrespect, but
I got that feeling from you. Like, I can fuck with you and I don't worry about, you know, negativity.
So do that energy that y'all got together, that y'all, since y'all just met and bonded with each other, you know what I'm saying? Do that come out in the music when y'all creating the music? Like how was y'all creative process going into making them two songs that y'all made already? How was the creative process like going into it? You know what I'm saying? How was the feeling was? Before and after.
If I hear the beat, the song is coming. We just like clicked. Once I hear the beat, the words just start coming.
Lou like me, like he definitely like me. Like I basically, when I hear a beat, I kind of already know what I want to say to it, and he like that too. So it's not like every time we put a beat on together, it only took like maybe 1 or 2 days for us to come up with a verse or some shit like that. So
it took me like
so the energy. Yeah.
I'm a writer too, but
my mind's always racing. So.
That's a fact.
I always got thoughts in my head, like I said, I watch movies and shit. I write about a movie I saw and make it a song. You know, just I'm inspired by the world, life, and everything.
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
so, like, what could y'all tell someone coming up that's in the game that want to pursue the game and chase this dream?
Take criticism, but never give up and always be yourself. Mm. Because people will try to change you. But be you for yourself. Satisfy yourself first before you satisfy the next person.
And don't ever let nobody try to tell you that you can't do something in life. Don't ever listen to the negative things that people throw at you. Don't ever, because the shit that people throw at you is only a perception of them not being able to make it for themselves.
Yeah.
So they probably, you know what I'm saying? Just don't let the he say she shit take you down.
If it was one thing that you knew about the industry that you didn't know before you started this career in music, what would that be?
Don't be gullible to somebody that shoots you something, thinking that they're gonna help you with your dreams, because 90% it be people that just take advantage of you. And it took me a while to realize that, but an incident with, I don't even want to say who, but an incident recently made me realize that. So that's what I'm gonna say. Don't take nothing. Don't take what people tell you to for granted.
Do it with gas you just to get your money.
Yeah,
that's a fact.
And a lot of scammers out there, so be careful. This game ain't no joke. It will rob you blind, and you'll never get nothing out of it. Especially now.
So, where can we find your the song that y'all just made or y'all music?
So we're on DistroKid. So DistroKid goes to all the platforms: Spotify, Apple Music. You know, drops from Dole, Louis the Franchise, Future and Chronic, my songbird. We got a song called Not to Remember. Link me up, baby. Antidote Incorporated on Instagram, Louis the Franchise Instagram, Facebook. Louis the Franchise, all over.
And you can find my music on DistroKid at Official Chronic 42. Plus, I got music coming on my YouTube page. It's my link is at YouTube, Trackmaster Hardspitter. I have all my content on there.
Y'all gonna be making a video for the song that y'all got coming up?
Soon. We're trying to get it there. You know what I'm saying? Like,
everything's still in the works.
Yeah, trying to build it up, the anticipation. Like, I feel like once you put a video out, the song becomes dated. Yeah. It's like, I feel like I want to reach people first, so then let them see the video.
Have y'all performed it before?
Yeah, we performed it before all over.
All right. How was the feedback?
Great,
then
let the crowd be singing the hook
that
the first verse
is
over.
And it hasn't been one time where we ain't get booed or nothing like that.
All right, so that's what we gonna do, man.
Hustle music,
I gotta
baby.
Get that on here. I gotta get that on Whole We Rap TV, man. Y'all ready for that? Y'all ready for that performance for Whole We Rap?
Definitely, yes, always ready, sir. Baby.
All right, let's do it, man.
Go, Kishi.
Appreciate you.